see about the proxy design pattern, theory, principles and real life examples. In the next video, we will try to cover the proxy design pattern, practical implementation using Java. So first, what is a proxy? A proxy means in place of or representing or on behalf of. So this is the general meaning of proxy. So please try to watch this video completely so that you could get the proxy design pattern in a detailed manner, because I have included the real life example of proxy design pattern. So this is the real life example, this is the illustration of the real life example of proxy design pattern. So please try to watch the video completely before, please don't skip this video. And then placeholder for another object to control the access. For example, there are two objects. So this is a real object. So this real object, the placeholder for another object to control the object. This is the real object. To access this real object, there is some another object. This is a proxy object. It will try to control the access. If suppose a client is trying to access this real object, this proxy object will come into act and it will try to check whether client has a permission, and client can based on various criteria, this proxy object will try to reply to the client whether that client has access to this real object or not. And then the third principle, proxy is the object that is being called by client to access the real object behind the screen. So this is a client. This client knows only this proxy object. The client doesn't aware about this real object. This proxy object will try to manage those the internal things, and it will try, this proxy object will try to contact this real object, and it will try to get the relevant information and data, and this proxy object will be served to the client. So this is second, this is third point. And then proxy pattern represents the functionality of another class. So this is the real object, real class object. The functionalities of this class object, the functionalities of the main object is replicated by this proxy object. Virtual, there are three types of proxy that are widely used in industry. The first one is virtual proxy, is a placeholder for expensive to create object. For example, and then the real object is only created when a client requests to access the object. For example, if a client is trying to access the student data of a particular student, for example, the client is accessing the student ID 1 data. Here, the student doesn't aware about the real object at all. It will see that there is some object. This is a proxy object. The client knows that there are some object that will be served for the request. The client will know the real object won't be created until the client requests the actual thing. Till that time, this proxy would be shown to the client. When a client actually requests that, then only the real object would be created. For example, student ID 1 is the actual request. During the runtime, on the fly, the student ID 1 data would be fetched from database, and the actual data would be converted to the real object. That real object would be served to the client. So this is the procedure for the proxy design pattern, virtual proxy. And the remote proxy. Remote proxy provides a local representative for an object that resides in different address space. For example, if the actual data or actual object present in the various address spaces, the client doesn't aware about those things. The client knows there will be some object that will be served when we raise a request. So here the proxy object would handle those things. The proxy object would get the object from the better address spaces for the particular request. And then protective proxy controls access to a sensitive master object. For example, I have already explained about this example in the previous video. If you're studying in college or some other institutions, you would have some lab session, and during those lab session you can access the internet. If you are trying to access social websites like Facebook, WhatsApp, like that, using your college or your institution network internet, then there will be some proxy server which won't allow you to access the Facebook server or WhatsApp server. Here, this is acting as a protective proxy. It's protecting the actual requests based on the various criteria. So we will try to relate this with the real life example. This is the best example according to me for explaining the proxy design pattern using real life example. For example, consider there is a person named John. He is trying to get 500 rupees from his account. So he is having an account in XYZ bank. So what it do is, you would have two options to withdraw 500 rupees from bank. The first approach is visiting the bank. This is the first approach. In the first approach, what you do is, you would try to visit the bank and then you would fill the challan, withdraw challan, and you will try to hand over that withdraw challan to the cashier, and that cashier would check the credentials, whether the account number is valid or not, whether the sufficient funds are present or not, like that. After that, that cashier would return 500 rupees to John. This is the first approach. Here, John is spending money as well as time for withdrawing 500 rupees. For example, consider John is residing at location A, bank is residing at location B. The distance between A and B is 5 kilometers. To cover the 5 kilometers, John is traveling using bike. So for that, he needs to fill some amount of petrol. For that, he needs to spend some amount of money and then time. So to travel 5 kilometers, it would take some time. So by using the first approach, John is spending both money and time for withdrawing 500 rupees. This is the second approach. This is the second approach where John visits the nearest ATM and then he uses the bank debit card and the swipes that debit card in the ATM machine, and he enters the required credentials like PIN number and other stuff, and he is entering the 500 rupees in the withdrawal category. Here, that ATM machine will act as a proxy object. It will try to communicate with the real object called bank, and it will check whether that account has sufficient balance, and it will check the other credentials, and the bank real object will reply those information to the actual proxy object, and that proxy object would serve to the data to John. Here, the proxy object is playing the major role behind the scheme. This proxy object is handling the requests on behalf of us. So by following the second approach, John is saving both time and money, because nowadays ATM is present on every street. So he could save both money and time to withdraw 500 rupees. So in real life, we are using the proxy design pattern at every point of our life. In software applications also, we are following proxy design pattern for some use cases. So you need to first analyze the use case, and you need to check whether that use case could be fit with the proxy design pattern or not. So these are the things about the proxy design pattern. If you want to learn more things about the software design pattern, then you could buy software design pattern book. The book link would be present in the description box of this video. So thanks for watching this video.